Early osteoarthritis can be treated with energy system or without medicine. Osteoarthritis can be treated with energy system or without medicine.
Good. Actually, every painkiller, if you are using for osteoarthritis, you know the painkiller kills. Because now we know every painkiller is a stimulant for a heart attack in the next 5 years. So use as less painkillers as possible. I use New York University Hospital, they use osteoarthritis, a simple treatment which our pundits used to use in the old days. They take castor oil, you know castor oil? They dip a thick cloth in castor oil, squeeze it and tie it around the joint which is painful and give steam there. Not hot water bottle because it's not 100 degrees, steam there. And I tell you, 90% of the pain goes away. Very effective. And of course, we have a device, electromagnetic device, which can be kept there and it will open up the blood vessels and the pain will go gradually, but it will take time. But this one will immediately help you with that. Because there is an enzyme inside called heat shock protein 70, HSP70. And this heat will stimulate that and then the vessels open and the new blood vessels come and the patient feels better.
We would love to know about that device which you have invented.
Don't worry about that device. Now that device of course is an electromagnetic energy producing device which can be used for heart attack, stroke, everything. But what I am now trying to do is devise a jacket and a belt for normal human beings who are in the IT industry. Because they are getting only 40 to 70 hertz energy and killing themselves. So I'll give them 0 to 30 like the earth gives you because they don't walk barefoot. They don't swim. So I have to give them a belt, they like it. So I'm trying to getting it. It's almost ready. So we are doing that. In North India, you can use a jacket because in South India, it's very warm to use the jacket. So we give them a belt.
As M-Pharm students, what can we do for betterment?
M-Pharm students can, I have written an article. It's for the health of the pharmaceutical industry because reductionist chemicals that you are studying now, they are all dextrorotatory. And body molecules are levorotatory. So it's a square plug in a round hole. Now, all herbal medicines, which I'll give you a reference if you want, read this, write down. Mitochondria as chi, C-H-I, C is energy. Mitochondria as chi, okay? Author's name is Douglas C. Wallace. Douglas C. Wallace. W-A-L-L-A-C-E. And the journal is Genetics, Genetics. Year is 2008. Volume is 179. And page is 727. Read this article. What it tells you is, he has a chip called MIT chip, which studies at the mitochondrial level, which you can't imagine. You give a reductionist drug, the minute it goes to the stomach and the body knows it, it says, oh, this is poison, I don't know what it is, so throw it into the liver. So it damages the liver and the liver tries to damage the drug. And what comes out, you studied in your textbook called first pass effect. Right? Do you know first pass effect? No? Oh, but pharmacy, you are doing pharmacy and don't know first pass effect? You know first pass effect. Okay, don't worry. Now, he gave herbal drugs, Tibetan, Chinese and Indian. And when it goes inside, it's levorotatory. That means it's like food. So the body said, oh, it's my food, I will use it. So it doesn't go to the liver, it doesn't anything good if it does. Now I told the pharmacy people, don't do this golden triangle reverse thing. You take a herb and say, I will study it in the Western way. No. You take a herb, study that directly on human beings because the toxicology is already studied. And you study the original pharmacology of which is called Drivya Shastra in Ayurveda. And then you do your human studies or animal studies on that. And then you can toxicity if you want to study, you can do animal studies. For example, we did a study on nano silver. If you can get silver in nano form because our old grannies used to say drink water in a silver cup. In temples they keep the teertha in silver bowl. Because no germ survives in silver. And we did nano silver. We have a technique of doing nano silver. Because water is a structure which is found out recently. A lot of loose bonds. So in the bond we put a silver And this is so effective on so many tricks. Malaria, for example. You know, I wanted this study for malaria in the Malaria Research Institute in Delhi. The director said, no, this is all bullshit. This is all, you know, rubbish. So I told him, sir, please do it and let us see. He said, he refused. Then after some time, he wanted some help from me because his daughter was not getting a medical seat. She wanted to be a doctor. He came to me. He said, will you some help me to get a medical seat? I said, I'll help provided you study this. He studied that. And then he got so excited. Then he came running to me, sir, this is so good. It must be used in human beings immediately. So I apply for a license. I don't get it. You know how to get license in India. I can't get it. Then we did a study in Africa. 100 patients of falciparum malaria, in 2 days time the malaria disappeared and the patient became all. We published that in a indexed peer reviewed journal. But what to do? You can't, because it is money that matters now. It's money. Money that matters.
So final concluding question, sir.
Thank you.
What is your opinion about knee replacement?
What?
Knee replacement.
If your knee is very, very bad and you can't do nothing about it, replace the knee like Vajpayee and be on the wheelchair. Some of you will do well, I'll tell you, not everybody is bad, but good. If you, it's good for you. When it is bad, of course it happens sometimes, you can't help it. But I didn't say knee replacement is bad. I only said that should be a last resort. Try everything else as a last resort. Spare part surgery should be the last resort. It's very nice. It's very, very fashionable though. Because we all want quick relief, no? We want quick relief. Your osteoarthritis, you sit in the sun and you get some vitamin D, your osteoarthritis will come down. Your bones will become younger. I have one request for all our friends. Difference of opinion will be there. Now you think, you have an opinion, you read in your textbook this way. Supposing someone says just exactly the opposite, don't be angry and don't pounce on him. You say, okay, I will find out whether this person has some possibility of being right. In which case I can correct myself. Years ago when I wrote that polio drop should not be given to malnourished children in India because it's very bad, I had a case against me by the government. And when I submitted all the data in the court and they found I might win, they withdrew the case. And the Knowledge Commission, you see here, Sam Pitroda and all, there was a vice chairman of the Knowledge Commission called Dr. Pushpa Bhargava. Pushpa Bhargava. This scientist resigned from the Knowledge Commission because he opposed polio vaccination in poor children. And he resigned and wrote an article, which you please read, about malnourishment and all. Article is called The Politics of Polio in the Hindu 1999. Please read that. It's a one full page article. Very good article because Pushpa Bhargava is a scientist, not a fool like me. Okay. We must have tolerance for others. When Simmalvi said doctors should wash their hands in soap and water before you deliver a woman with the data. With the data from his hospital which he had collected over 10 years, we showed midwives who delivered the women, 90% survived. Doctors who delivered the women, 90% died of puerperal sepsis. Then he had another opinion, very clear thing. His own professor of anatomy, who was teaching him anatomy, dropped a scalpel on his hand while he was dissecting the human body. And that man died of puerperal fever, just like a pregnant woman. So he said, you are getting the germs from the dead body when you dissect it in the anatomy. They can come and with the same hand you deliver the woman. So wash your hands. Do you know what they did? They jailed him. Called him mad and jailed him. And continued to do what they did, but they didn't look at the data. So please, one request. I have written an article. If you want to think out of the box, be a scientific agnostic. But when you get data, be a scientific fanatic. Data should be analyzed very scientifically, but think out of the box, you should. And out of the box can be think, you can think out of the box only if you forget what you know. If you think the book is the same thing, what? The greatest thinker was Karl Popper. Karl Popper was a professor of science philosophy in the London School of Economics in the 50s and 60s, like a colossus. Karl wrote, I quote, knowledge advances not by repeating known things, but by refuting false dogmas.